Thank you all for this recognition. I wish I could stand here and say that we've gotten more done. I am the son of a woman who immigrated to this country with her parents, having survived the Holocaust in Warsaw, Poland. And they were really they were the remnant of their family after that terrible war. They made the mistake of not leaving when they could have left before the war, and left Warsaw finally several years after the war was ended, went to Stockholm for a year, went to Mexico City for a year, and then finally got to New York City, to the United States, which was the only country in the world that they believed they could rebuild their shattered lives, and they did. My mom was the only one that spoke English, enrolled herself in school there. She helped them find an apartment, and they started over again, and they were able to rebuild those shattered lives in a country that embraced them and saw the contribution that they could make. And I know of no more patriotic people than my grandparents. And what they did for us, what they did for me and for my brother and my sister to enable us to have a much better life than they had, I will never forget. And I think that's what this fight really is all about. The job that I had before this, as Ted mentioned, was being superintendent of the Denver Public Schools. School district that's 57% Latino, 20% African American, 20% Anglo, a school district that has numerous children that were born outside of the United States, but know no other country than the United States as their own, and who discover today, about the time they get to the ninth grade, that this isn't their country in the view of our laws, and that the contribution they want to make and the demonstrated commitment they want to provide, whether it's going on and getting their education or going on to serve in our military and make any other kind of contribution, is not yet recognized by us. That's why we have to pass the DREAM Act, the real DREAM Act. But we need to do much more than that. We need to have comprehensive immigration reform in this country. We have to fix this broken immigration system. And it might interest you to know that in my state, which is a third Republican, a third Democratic, and a third Independent, and has both urban areas and rural areas, immigration is very often the second issue that I hear about after the economy. And it's everybody from people that are in agriculture in the state, to people that are running high-tech companies, to our ski resorts, to the moms and dads of the kids in the Denver Public Schools and other school districts. Like this issue comes up over and over again. What makes this issue different than some of the other issues that I work on, and the reason why we care about it so much, is that I have every confidence that in time we are going to fix our deficit and our debt problem, and we need to. I have every confidence that this economy will grow again, even if it's in spite of the dysfunction in Washington, D.C. But I worry that on the immigration issue, that if we can't find a way to have a civil conversation about this and to build a broad coalition around this issue, the promises that were made and kept to my parents and my grandparents may be something in the past and not something for the future. That's why we have to keep after it. I know how frustrating this work can be, and I think we should take that frustration and channel it into building, as I said a minute ago, as broad a coalition as possible. That coalition is out there, and it's waiting for leadership that you have provided, but we need more of it, and we've got to be fellow travelers in all this, and we will ultimately achieve this. I know we will achieve it, because it is more consistent with our principles than not fixing this problem at the end of the day. And our democracy and our economy are depending on us to get this right. So it's been a great privilege to work on these issues for these years. One other thing I wanted to mention, because Ali mentioned it earlier, we are now waiting for Washington, Colorado, where we've seen the work that Utah did around its compact, and we're working to use that vehicle, that mechanism, as a way to keep the conversation going in Colorado while we try to get things sorted out in Washington, D.C. So I'm sure I'm absolutely in no way worthy of this award, but I can't tell you how grateful I am to have received it. Thank you for having me.